Hello, this is your daily dose of news from On Manorama. I am your host, Susan Jo Phillip, and these are the major news stories of the day. First, we have a shocking news from Punjab. Four soldiers were killed in firing at Bathinda military station. Next is an update on the wild elephant Arikomban. Kerala High Court has asked the state government to find a suitable place to relocate the animal in a week. A day after 50 people were killed, Myanmar military justifies the deadly attack on what they called an insurgent ceremony. It said that if civilians were also killed, it was because they were being forced to help the terrorists. Twitter owner Elon Musk said he was unaware of why Twitter India pulled down the post on BBC documentary critical of Modi. And about COVID, India logged 7,830 cases, the highest in over 7 months. Let's get into the details. Four army personnel of an artillery unit were killed in a firing incident at the Bathinda military station in Punjab early Wednesday, with the state police terming it a case of fratricide. An army said the incident took place at around 4:30 a.m. and that it deployed quick reaction teams and cordoned off the area. It has been ascertained that in the unfortunate incident, four army jawans of an artillery unit succumbed to gunshot injuries sustained during the incident. No other injuries to personnel or loss damage to property have been reported, the Army's Southwest Command said in a statement. Kerala High Court on Wednesday said that its decision to shift the rock elephant Arikomban, which has been creating havoc in the Chinnakanal and Shandampara regions in Idukki for close to two decades, was final and there will not be any change in that. The court also asked the state government to implement the same within a week, referring to the large-scale protest in Parambikulam, where Arikomban was supposed to be relocated. The court said that it showed how selfish people can be. Even for helping other people, they are not allowing the transfer of the elephant. This is selfish, the court observed during the trial of the case. The court also asked the government to find any other place if Parambikulam is no longer an option. Myanmar's military said it carried out a deadly attack on a village gathering organized by its insurgent opponents this week, and if civilians were also killed, it was because they were being forced to help the terrorists. Up to 100 people, including children, were killed in Tuesday's airstrike in northwest Myanmar, according to media reports, making it the deadliest in a recent string of military air attacks. Myanmar has been in turmoil since a 2021 coup ended a decade of tentative reform that included rule by a civilian government led by Nobel Peace Prize laureate Aung San Suu Kyi. Elon Musk said on Wednesday that he did not know what exactly happened when Twitter took down content related to a documentary critical of Prime Minister Narendra Modi earlier this year, adding that some rules related to social media content were quite strict in India. In January, India ordered the blocking of a BBC documentary that questioned Modi's leadership during the 2002 Gujarat riots, saying that even sharing of any clip via social media was barred. The government had issued orders to Twitter to block over 50 tweets linking to the video of the documentary, Kanchan Gupta, an advisor to the government, had said. India has witnessed a sharp rise in active COVID-19 cases, with 7,830 new infections on Wednesday, the highest in 223 days. As per the official data of the Union Health Ministry, the count of active cases in the country has increased to 40,215. The death toll due to the disease has increased to 5,31,016, with 16 new fatalities being reported, two each in Delhi, Punjab and Himachal Pradesh, and one each in Gujarat, Haryana, Maharashtra, Tamil Nadu and Uttar Pradesh, and five reconciled by Kerala, the data updated at 8 a.m. stated. And that brings us to the end of this episode. Thanks for listening to Daily News Dose, hosted by me, Susan Jo Phillip. Daily News Dose podcast is produced by Vishnu Muralidharan, with technical production by Idea Brew Studios. Follow on manorama.com for detailed updates on the latest news, and be sure to come back tomorrow.